traveling bachelor needs for society someone whose knowledge is marked by variety, valley experienced, fame for sobriety, and let his name be John, Robert, or Sam. Up in the morning with strict punctuality, never unwell with the greatest vitality, character free from the slightest rascality. There's your exceptional valet de sham. Genuine valet, genuine valet, genuine valet, not valet de sham. He must know Bradshaw by heart and his ABC, know how to travel by land and his way by sea. Nothing about him you must of the gamey see, honest and bright as a beautiful day. He must wear of a certain gentility, showing ability by versatility, no imbecility, general utility, as the theatrical managers say. That is the role you engage him to play. Then he must laugh when you are at your rummiest, also be solemn when you're at your dummiest, cheerful, respectful when you're at your chummiest, never presume to take a liberty. He must be hairdresser, butler, confectioner, polisher, brusher, and not a mud spectioner, carpenter, courier, gamekeeper, lectioner, and on occasion your secretary, and on occasion your secretary. Good at accounts as an arithmetician, musical but not of course a musician, and when you're ill both a nurse and physician, being abroad your apothecary, knowing all London of which he's a denizen, ready at carving hair, partridge or venison, and before meals bowing low for a benison, like an Archbishop of Canterbury. Like an Archbishop, like an Archbishop, like an Archbishop of Canterbury. He must be something of tailor or tinker, to stitch on a button or mend broken link or two, able in winter to make a hot drink or two, or some cold punch on a tropical day. Up in topography, good in orthography, and not a blot on his private biography, for such a valley you'll search for geography. Wish you may get him, that's all I can say.